Good morning, fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market preparation video for December 31st, 2018. So as we ring in the end of 2018 and ring in the new year, 2019, we're looking at a market that's showing some bullishness this morning, trying to gap up significantly. Now, what's going on here? Well, the president came out and made a statement that he had a conversation with China, the China's leader, about trade negotiations, hung up the phone and apparently said that it went well. So the market is responding to that. Now, what's interesting to me is even though we're getting this massive gap up this morning, about 250 points in gap up this morning, currently, we didn't see that kind of excitement from Asian stocks overnight. So Asian stocks, although ended up the day mixed, and the Nikkei was actually down on the day by 60 points. So I'm not sure that they saw the same thing that the president saw or picked up from that conversation. Also, European stocks don't seem to be all that convinced either that this is over, because European stocks are pretty close to flat this morning, not really responding well. So this gap up this morning is a little bit suspicious to me. And there was even reports just shortly after the president's comments that the gap between the two sides, key issues on the two sides, are still very, very far apart. So I'm going to be a little bit suspicious of this gap up this morning. First, with it being New Year's Eve holiday trading, we can probably expect volumes to drop very quickly today as a result of the holiday. And we're also pressing right up against some significant levels of resistance. So it's wonderful to see the gap. I'm all for seeing bullishness. Believe me, it's been a nice change to see this relief rally. But let's kind of keep in mind that really nothing has changed here. In fact, nothing at all has changed here. And we could probably expect those lighter volumes to create some issues today. So as we pop up into this resistance right here, I'm going to pull this back here just for a second. As we pop up into this major resistance right here, I'm a little bit concerned as we move to this level for the potential of that pop and drop. Now, what's a pop and drop? Pop and drop is we gap up on the morning information, we gap up in here, and it's not supported by buyers. We don't see those buyers come in. As a matter of fact, what we see is profit takers, and the market pulls back. So I will be watching closely for that potential this morning. Not saying that that's exactly what's going to happen. I am not trying, please understand, I do not try to predict the market here. I'm not in any way, shape, or form suggesting that's what's going to happen. What I'm saying is I'm going to be a little bit cautious until I see that there's actual buyers coming in to support that gap and push this higher. So what I would need to see is in a short-term chart, possibly that gap up open, market gaps up here at the open. I want to see those buyers, if we get any kind of a pullback, I want to see those buyers stepping up to push the market higher. After that little bit of a pullback or a rest, consolidation would be even better. Nice little tight consolidation than pushing higher. Until that time, I'm going to be a little bit suspicious of this, just simply because the way the market has, well, seeing what happened in Asia, seeing what's happening in Europe, it just doesn't seem to coincide with so much excitement when really nothing has changed. Let's take a look at the SPY really quick. SPY, also nice rally back, bouncing up. we'll be pushing up toward this level of resistance right here. And you can see we've got these price resistance levels right in here that we're trying to deal with. And as we push up to this upper band of that resistance, we want to watch for that possibility here again of that pop and drop, that failure pattern. Hopefully that doesn't occur. Hopefully we can carry on through and, you know, next week, or well, later this week, I should say, rally up into this more significant level of resistance here on the SPY. So let's hope those bulls actually do follow through and hold on. Let's take a look at the NASDAQ. NASDAQ pushing up here toward this, you know, it's, I guess I should say, it's in the middle of a gap. We have a significant resistance right up through here, but there is a little bit of price resistance right in this area. So we're pushing against that right there. We want to watch that closely. And this gap up this morning, we'll have to keep an eye on. If it can push up into here, awesome. If those bulls can continue to push on through. But then keep in mind that we are pushing up toward this downtrend, and there is still a lot of work before we're out of the woods here. So this rally back, really, we have to kind of take it with a grain of salt and be a little bit careful with it. It's been wonderful to see the bull rally, but there are reasons to be a little bit cautious here as we start approaching those resistance levels. Let's take a look at IWM real quickly. IWM poked up here on Friday, poked up here to this resistance level, and then reversed, coming back down, leaving us a little bit of a shooting star type pattern here, right at price resistance. Now this morning we're gapping back up to this level. Whether or not the bulls can deal with this level and push us on through has yet to be seen. Gapping up to it may be a good sign first thing in the morning, but if they cannot hold on to it, we could see that pullback. So be really, really careful, and I would say a little bit slow to react to this morning's pop. Make sure there's actually buying coming in to support that. Let's take a look at the VIX here quickly. The VIX pulling back here. Nice pulling back, a little relaxation and some of the fear. We held this resistance here so far. That's a good sign. We want to continue to see that pulling back and testing these levels of support, and hopefully breaking down through those levels and having that fear drift out. What we don't want to see is on this pop this morning, we get that drive down in the VIX initially in the morning, and then that bounce off of that level. We do not want to see that. We don't want to see those bulls fail here. We want to see them hang on and continue to push higher, forcing that fear index lower. But if those bears happen to come in and bounce off of this area, and we see selling going into this afternoon, we'll want to be really watchful of this area where we could spring back higher here in the VIX. Take a quick look at T21.22, the 4-week new high, new low ratio. As you can see, in the last few days, we have just soared here. It's another one of those spikes that I hate to see. We get overexcited and we spike. And when that occurs, we invite the opportunity for profit takers to come in and push it down. We just go too far too fast. And having covered about 1,500 points in the Dow in the last three trading days, a little bit too far too fast maybe. So don't be surprised to see a little bit of selling, particularly heading into the holiday. Remember, Tuesday the market is closed. We will reopen on Wednesday. Also remember that we're going to start to see the new Congress coming in next week, and that is certainly going to create some market turmoil as they continue to try and to negotiate the reopen of the federal government. So lots of things still facing this market, a lot of uncertainty out there. It is wonderful to see maybe the beginning of a bottoming pattern, but let's keep in mind, it is very rare, very rare to see a true V bottom. Normally we will rally, we'll find a resistance point in here someplace, we come back down, we bounce around for a while as we set a bottom in the market. By the way, that's exactly what happened right over here in February. Big sharp rally, and then right back down, and we bounced around before this really started any kind of recovery. So keep in mind, bottom patterns normally take weeks, if not months, to recover from. So this is not going to go away anytime soon, in my opinion. This is going to be a lot of back and forth, so kind of watch that close. Let's take a look at that economic calendar here today. Economic calendar, we have some bond settlements, we have some bond auctions, we have the Dallas Fed survey today. I wouldn't expect these to move the market around much at all. And then bond announcements and a bond auction later today. So pretty quiet. Obviously, the market is closed on Tuesday. When we reopen on Wednesday, we have some big stuff coming up. We've got Powell speaking here on Friday, and the employment situation number on Friday, big number there. And then of course ISM is always one of those numbers that can move the market around significantly. So let's keep an eye on those as we plan our week ahead. With that, everyone, hey, I want to wish you all a fantastic day. I want to wish you great profits. Guys, there are trades out there to be watching and be paying attention to, trades that might be coming up out of a bottom. You know, for example, Facebook could come up out of this bottom, break this downtrend. Stocks like JD coming up out of these bottoming patterns. There's still a lot of work that has to be done before we really see massive recovery here. We want to see proof that they can hold these levels. You know, when a downtrend is broken, the first thing I want, I don't chase the break of the downtrend. In fact, I'm very, very patient on this. I want to see these price action moves break through some resistance levels and then prove they can hold it, and then see buyers coming in after that. That's when I start getting long stocks like this. So there's a lot of those patterns starting to develop. We're seeing those in a lot of places. So keep an eye on those charts and be very, very focused to that price action. 2019 is likely going to provide us some really great swing trading and even some a little bit longer term position trading, as long as we stay very focused on price. Don't predict, just wait and follow that price action. There'll be some great trades going forward. So I look forward to a great 2019. I wish you all a fantastic New Year's Eve celebration. Wish you all a very prosperous 2019. And everyone, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, do me a favor, click that subscribe button on YouTube, follow me button on Facebook, click those thumbs up buttons, and leave a comment. You guys are just awesome about that. Thank you so much for all that you have done to support the YouTube channel this year. You guys, I'm very humbled by that. Thank you so much. And please feel free to share these videos with any friends and family. So with that, everyone, I want to wish you all a fantastic evening with your friends and family, whatever you plan to do. Be safe, be wise. We'll see you back here bright and early Wednesday morning. Everyone, take care and Happy New Year.